Star Woman on the Breeze, profiling a woman who is causing waves in her sphere of influence.
All right, like I said, our star women, my Charamba and Cynthia Mari, have brought along Sandra Muyengwa. She's a lawyer with the Justice for Children organization. Sandra, good morning and welcome.
Morning, Ayatu.
All right, we just want you to give the technical backdrop to all this that we're talking about. Maybe you can tackle the consequences that you've seen in your work of gender-based violence, the consequences of gender-based violence on the family, and also who should play what role to reduce domestic violence. We are here celebrating the efforts that Mai Charamba and Cynthia are making as artists, but who else should play what role in our society as we try and tackle GBV?
Thank you, Ayati. You will find that it is everyone's responsibility to tackle gender-based violence. More specifically, if we look at the law, anyone can make an application for a domestic violence protection order. If I see my neighbor who is being abused, but for some reason or the other they have failed to go and get a protection order, I can still do that on their behalf. So you'll find that it is not up to the victim or the survivor who is under those circumstances. It is everyone's responsibility. Also, looking at the special category of children, you'll find that where children are involved, it's like there are two elephants which are fighting, and the hardest hit is the grass, in this case, which are the children. Again, as an outsider, if I see that children are in this circumstance and they are being affected, but the people who should protect them are not protecting them, even as an outsider, I'm mandated to go in and make an application for a protection order on behalf of the children so that they are protected. Most of the time we think of domestic violence, we think of physical violence. But in terms of children, you should also even think about the emotional abuse, what is happening to what in their minds on what they are seeing. Also think about the economical abuse. If the father is spending all his money at the beer hall, they don't have school fees, they don't have food. That is a form of domestic violence. And again, we should protect them. Again, it's everyone's responsibility. We should not sit back and watch and say, this is not my home, someone else will come and do it. It's still our responsibility.
All right, speaking of emotional effects, someone is coming through on WhatsApp. She says, Askana kuroerwa mbereki wakatarisa is really painful. Ndakakura ndichiona mai vangu vachirohwa nababa mumba zvekuti it affected me kusvika ndaroorwa. Ndiri kutarisa every man as evil up until ndakazoona kuti the guy I got married to is just a saint. So these things really, you know, they have far reaching effects. How best through your music? Let's talk about this project now. Have you written particular songs for this? And how exactly are you going to use your influence, Mai Charamba and Cynthia, to get the message across?
We are in the process of writing a song. I think we want to appeal to Sesha Taura,
Sandra,
because it's not only physical violence, emotional, and vanava no affect. So we want to try and put everything, every subject in the song. Kuti map is the community. It's not only vanu tu varuku affecteka, but varuku affecta vana concentrations au kuchikoro kakurure kese zvokutaura sister pamunanto kura achitovenga kuti kana ngona mukomana anobva ofuka kuti pamwane mweya uri paari hadi kuroorwa, but zimuka it's because of that emotional background yakaita yakamukanganisa. So it goes a long way.
Yeah.
I think Cynthia.
As for me, besides obviously working with Mai Charamba, I already have a song called Motonga Obviri. I performed it at the Nama on Saturday.
I love that track.
In that track, I'm actually talking to the girls. I'm saying to the girls, if you've suffered any type of abuse, if you've been through so much bad stuff or experiences, mm-hmm. don't forget that you're special. Don't let those experiences bring you down, because I know that sometimes things like that. You're not worth it. Mm-hmm. So you're not worth being happy. You're not worth being somebody. You're not worth making it in life. Mm-hmm. And I'm urging the girls to keep on believing in themselves. Don't let anyone burn out your fire. Mm-hmm. That fire that makes us desire to make it and, you know, gives us that power to work hard towards our goals. Mm-hmm. So for me, it's more like saying to girls, I want you to empower yourself. Don't rush into marriage. Mm-hmm. Get your education. Think about your future, what you want to do. Mm-hmm. So that if you ever have a situation like this, you're not stuck in a home, because at 16 or at 18 or at 20, how to survive on your own, how to stand up on your own two feet, so that you're also empowered mm-hmm. to make a decision for your life. Mm-hmm. And I think I would also want to say, I'm saying this to the family, as mwana. Mm-hmm. So that us, the girl child, can grow mm-hmm. happy and become whole human beings when we're adults.
All right. We first run out of time. I'm going to have to ask Patricia to jump back on this one. This is a comment coming through on WhatsApp. Ladies, please note that as long as we continue to look at gender-based violence from the point that women are just victims when it comes to gender issues, we are wasting our time. Men and women are equally guilty in this challenge. Women are verbally and emotionally very abusive. We seem to overlook confronting the women. When we take a one-sided approach, women tend to think they are perfect.
Wow, what a comment. And I'd like to say to that, Ayati, that you see, men, if you work with organizations like Padari, for example, because mm-hmm. Padari work with men, mm-hmm. and what Padari have done, and Padari is one of the partners for World Education Incorporated Bantwana, mm-hmm. they're focusing on men and they're working with men to champion change in the communities, mm-hmm. and there's a lot of work happening out in the communities, and this is because they say that every mm-hmm. man is a potential perpetrator mm-hmm. of gender-based violence. Mm-hmm. So women, in most cases, women are the victims. In most cases, we're not saying in all cases. There are mm-hmm. some cases where young boys are the victims. So what I'd like to say is the good thing is that we have partners. We're working as World Education Incorporated Bantwana. We have partners. Call us mm-hmm. if you're violated in mm-hmm. any way.